Hello everyone, my name is Teriprism, and welcome to Stories, the Path of Destinies. This game came out about a week ago, and I was going to upload this sooner than today, but I kind of got distracted with other games and Battleborn beta, so sorry about that. Now, what I know about this game? Well, this is a game that has basically stories really short, about 1 hour long per playthrough. But each of those stories reveals something else on a whole story. And then you replay it and choose different choices. And those work towards getting true ending instead of kind of like a game over ending that most of endings tend to be. Well, anyway, without further ado, let's just start playing this.
New Once game. Upon a time, the infamous rover Renardo plundered the floating isles. Then his mother called him to her deathbed.
Swear to me that you won't die on the gallows,
she rasped. Reluctantly, he swore. And he whiled away his days at home with music, cards, and wine. But the Emperor had changed. He'd been good once, a shy, almost humble toad. He'd built universities. But then people started whispering about mass graves in the woods. Midnight rituals, victims screaming. The Imperial Ravens would round up entire villages, and no one ever returned. The Ravens had come to Ubar scouting for ancient books said to be of great power. But the librarians had hidden the books, so they'd burnt the librarians. The citizens, outraged, had driven them off. The Ravens had come back with dropships. The kid had fled with one of those books. He was brave and dumb and wanted to join the rebellion. And Renardo had promised his mother he'd protect him.
Also, what I know about this, this is supposed to be kind of like a Bastion was. Action RPG and also having that narrator speaking in the background during the whole game. Which is quite, I believe, will be quite fun, actually. Not too many games do that. Quite long loading time here. Also, I will be...
down. Watching his city burn. Sorry, kid. Renardo told the kid. Look, if we give them the book, they'll leave you alone.
My mother died for this book!
I promised her I'd protect you. Oh, damn it. The kid had run off. With the book, of course. So Renardo had to run after him.
Well, I was about to say before I got interrupted by actual story that I will be playing on a PC and won't be using a gamepad for this but a keyboard and mouse, so let's see how that will affect my gameplay. Okay, and using a left mouse button attacks. Feels kind of like mobile-like control like so far.
Which probably was what was in their tiny brains. Hey, Renardo said. They cocked their heads at him. Pick on someone as ugly as you. Wait, that didn't come out right.
For the Emperor!
The Ravens cawed and rushed at him.
So, combo attacks too. And when enemies about to attack, I guess target that enemy and click attack to counter it. Let's see. Like that. Down he goes. And let's just rush towards that kid.
A dropship flew overhead. He hoped they hadn't noticed him. The kid.
Gotta say, I love this environment here. Interesting world to have these kind of floating islands. So hold attack to grab, and then aim and release it to throw. Like this. Yeah. Can I? Yes. I was able to throw him off the other side. Right.
The Gate of Heroes. Someone's idea of a joke, making the Skyship Docks a gated community. You needed a hero's sword to open it. And the kid was on the
so
other side.
So how did you
the
get
gate.
There?
Who
I want to know that.
You through.
Yeah,
promise
I want
me you'll
to
take
know
the
that.
Book to the rebels. Or I'm going to steal your ship. I'm not taking that damn book anywhere. And neither are you. Try
and you're not
me.
Taking my ship.
I have ship,
by the way.
Sword.
And
I guess
that,
I have.
The kid hopped away.
Well, of course, he was
had to hand it to the
kind
kid.
Of... If I understood
idiot.
Correctly, some kind of pirate.
Where was Renata going to get a hero sword?
I guess.
I could forge a hero sword here, but I'm going to need
from
all.
From here. Okay. I just need the ores first. Yeah. And I guess those ores are in this. Test here.
I hope nobody minds if I use this stuff.
Wind essence and three ores. Let's make this next level, level one. Look badass.
A hero sword.
Okay.
QED.
I wonder. I'm not familiar with that QED, what it means. Next level allows me to heal myself, apparently.
This is what he got for settling down
right.
and finding people to care about. The kid's mum had been a swell cook, and she'd laughed at Renato's jokes, even when he didn't know he'd made one. And the ravens had come to burn her.
Let's see.
And she'd made him promise to protect the kid.
Void Blade.
But she never told him where the book was.
Firestorm.
Just the kid.
Only four different swords. I thought there would have been more.
He came up to a ledge. It was too far to jump. There'd been a bridge here before, hadn't there? And there was Peter, giggling at him. How'd you get across? He asked the kid. Where'd you find a hook? I harped, said the kid. Wise-ass kid. Hey, look out behind you. Cute, said Renato.
Yeah, I think he knew better what's behind us. And let's deal with them.
It was time to talk some sense into the kid. Just hook his way across the ledge and chase the kid down. Thing was, he hadn't used his hook since he'd retired. He'd done it. Maybe if he meditated at that altar there, he'd remember his old skills.
Nice way to... tie in leveling up to game world instead of it just being hey you leveled up this is how you assign your skills. Instead, it's kind of woven into story, at least. So, 4 tiers of skills. The more truths you discover, the more tiers you unlock. Okay. And I can find info on skill tier. And skill points. Every other skill is apparently locked until I get this hoop one.
It was starting to come back to him. Something you never completely forgot. Like how to freeze time when attacking. The more he fought, the more he'd probably remember.
And also that freezing time when fighting sounds useful. Got it. So let's... That's quite a long reach it has. I don't want to hook that, I wanted to hook the longer or farther
away. And there
away.
Was the Farfarer. She was the fastest ship he'd ever known. She could do the Kestrel run in 12 furlongs. So the salesman told him. And something told
nice
him
Star Wars
the kid was about
reference.
To walk into an ambush. Stop! He shouted. I'm not giving you the book! Shouted the kid and took off. No! Peter!
Don't run!
But the kid ran for it, and a goggler nailed him with its eye.
Oh, poor kid. So I guess I don't want to get caught on that beam. Well, I kind of failed there. But I got it down at least.
The book was unburned. Next to it were the buckles from the kid's shoes. In a kid-sized pile of ashes. Damn it. Why hadn't he lied and told the kid he'd take the book to the rebels? The kid would be alive now. Really pissed off and betrayed, but alive. Oh, damn it. Renardo picked up the book. He couldn't let the Empire have it now. He was going to have to get it out of there. He'd be a wanted man. Probably have to join the rebellion just to have a place to dock. Well, he'd hated home life anyway.
Also, I love this small detail of wind picking up kids' ashes and blowing them away. Even if it's a little bit of morbid thing. But I love that small detail they had.
What was the big deal about this book, anyway? Maybe he should open it and find out. All that had been years ago. How many? The war was a blur. And now 3 Raven scout ships were chasing him. Where are you running, rebel? Poured the Raven captain over the loud hailer.
I love her.
Renardo
could
see them cranking up their catapults.
Small drawing of him.
Just going out for milk? Renardo yelled back. Where can you run? Laughed the Raven horribly. Far behind him, another city was burning. The dark cloud above its island was thousands of Imperial ships. The fleet was doing a thorough job. Take us!
Yeah, sounds like that.
I will spare your life! It cawed. The entire jury-rigged rebel fleet was only a few islands to the east. Beyond that were only the pillars of heaven. A sea of endless blood-colored tornadoes. The rebellion was out of time. Unless Renardo could bring a game-changer. Maybe he could. Renardo had found out where he could find the pieces of the Sky Ripper, the legendary weapon that had exiled the lost gods. Surely a legendary weapon could win the final battle. On the other hand, his old friend Lupino had sent Renardo a desperate message saying he had a brilliant scheme to save the rebellion. If Renardo could only rescue him. Renardo dived the Farfarer towards the abyss. As he felt the heat of the jet stream, the Raven ships peeled off, not stable enough to follow him down there. Now it was time to choose.
Lapino or the Sky Ripper?